Good morning, my YouTube friends. This is Monica from MyWyoStyle, and God loves you. I just wanted to bring you along while I make my bread. It's gluten-free, but I don't know if it's keto or not, but we really enjoy it. I hope you enjoy this video. I'm gonna be making it out of this gluten-free book, let's see, by Carol Fenster, and this is her recipe for her mix, and then you use this mix for different recipes in this book. So come along and follow me, and I'll show you how it's done. Okay guys, I'm gonna quadruple this recipe. So it asks us for 1.5 cups of sorghum flour times 3. It asks us for potato starch or cornstarch. I'm gonna use cornstarch this time, see how we like it. That's really messy. And yes, I use my hands. I'm old school. I wash my hands about 500 times when I'm cooking. So I'm never worried about germs, besides the fact that cornstarch is never fun to work with. Tapioca flour, it's 1 cup times 3. And these flours are so fine. And 1/2 cup of almond flour times 3. And I'm gonna mix this all up and I'll get right back with you when I'm done with that. Okay, let's see if I can get it in a situation that you can see it. I always stir really slowly, because some of these flours are sifted so finely that they're kind of it's so fine that it flies away. So if you can get all the flours combined slowly, the better. You don't want to get right in and just start mixing this fast, because it's gonna create a little dust, flour dust. So do it just really ever so gently when you're combining these flours. Once the heaviness of the sorghum flour and the almond flour combine, it's not as dusty. Just keep spinning your bowl around and get this all combined. Okay, the first thing we're gonna do is put 1 cup of warm water. One and a half teaspoons of active dry yeast. And 2 teaspoons of sugar. I'm going to mix that up so all that yeast gets wet. It's really hard to find yeast at the beginning of 2020, when the pandemic hit the hardest. a lot of people were trying to make bread because the shelves were emptying pretty fast. There's a way to make yeast too, and you might want to get on YouTube the next time that ever happens. You can actually make yeast. We're gonna let that sit for about 5 minutes. Okay. My yeast has been sitting for 5 minutes and it's gotten kind of bubbly. So now we're gonna add this to the mixing bowl. Make sure that I get all that yeast out of there. And now we're going to combine the flours, the dry ingredients. Here is 1.5 cups of the flour mixture that we made. It asks for 1 tablespoon of dried minced onion, but the last few times that I made it, it was just almost too much. But it was way too much onion flavor, so I'm only going to use 1/2 teaspoon of the garlic powder this time. And now it says to use 2 teaspoons of xanthan gum, and I'm not a real huge fan of it, so I'm going to use 1 teaspoon of it. Then 1 teaspoon of unflavored gelatin. One teaspoon of baking powder. Quarters teaspoon of salt. I love using the pink Himalayan salt. Now we're going to mix that up really good. Make sure to get that xanthan gum stirred in really nice, because as soon as it hits any kind of liquid, it does turn into a gummy consistency. So you want to make sure that that xanthan gum is really mixed in good. We are now going to add the rest of the wet ingredients. And this is 2 tablespoons of melted butter. Cider vinegar, and I make my apple cider vinegar. I don't know if it's going to be the right acid level that it needs, and this will be in a different video, but you can see the mother down here, so it's extremely healthy for you. And 2 eggs. When you drop your eggshell in there. We're going to beat this on low speed. So the weather is really funny today, and I had to put, let's see, I put another cup, I put another 2 cups of flour in it. But you want it to get to this consistency. It's going to be really soft and sticky. And I just have a muffin tin pan that I'm going to make these in. We're just going to have some sliders today. And I'm going to fill these about probably all the way to the top, so that way we can get a good bun for our sliders. We're going to let them double in size and bake them. I hope you guys are having a great day today. We woke up to fog this morning. It was pretty chilly. It's starting to warm up a little, so we can continue working on that patio that we're working on. I hope the weather holds out for us. We just want to get it done so that way we can enjoy the rest of the summer from our rocking chairs. I flattened these down as much as I could, and I started the oven on warm. Just going to put them in the oven and let them double in size, and then we'll bake them. Okay guys, these have doubled quite a bit, so I'm going to switch the oven over. Let me push them in the middle of the oven quick. Our temperature to 350. And give it a few minutes for it to come up to temp, and then we are going to bake them for 15 to 20 minutes. Okay guys, little hamburger buns came out of the oven. I'm gonna cut one open for you guys. They look amazing. Kind of like an English bread. Very moist and bready, bread-like. I'm so funny. But, can taste the onion. Other than that, it tastes just like real bread. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. And have a good rest of the day. God bless.